What's going on, guys? This is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. And today, we're going to be doing something really special, okay? If you've been following our channel for some time, you know that we'll constantly tell you guys to review your VODs. However, VOD review, you know, it's a tedious task and it takes dozens, if not hundreds of hours to get really good at them. You know, a lot of the time, you'll just be reviewing your gameplay and you'll be able to spot out the obvious mistakes, but the details are often missed. And that's why we have this brand new VOD replay analysis coaching over at ProGuys.com. Over there, we have professional level players who can review your gameplay and pinpoint every single thing you need to work on in order to improve. In addition to all of that, they're going to give you guys some advice which is tailored and personalized to each student so they improve at the fastest speed possible. The results, guys, after VOD review coaching session is staggering. In fact, in this video, we're going to be going over one of our students' replays, which was analyzed by a top-tier professional who's placed top 10 and nearly top 100 every single tournament. His name is Thresh. This student has improved a lot, and I'm sure you can too. So click that link in the description if you find this video useful. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Bunch of Crunch Army, here we go. It's time to sit back, relax, and grab some of my favorite candy. What is that, y'all? It's that Bunch of Crunch. Now let's get this going. For a little bit of context, the student being reviewed is called Noble. So Noble initially came to ProGuys looking for a coach to help him escape the throes of not being really good at competitive. At the time, he was really struggling with approaching fights and rotations, but has recently started dominating more and more high point arena lobbies and even joining high level scrims. Please keep in mind, this is but a summary of the entire analysis. So in this game, we've got Noble landing at Misty Meadows. Misty is a solid drop spot for competition. He lands in a really good area of Misty as well, with a lot of chests. So his drop spots gets an A+ from us. All right, so after looting up a good amount, Noble has a solid loadout and he's confident and he's able to fight. It was smart not to take an early 50-50, and honestly, this was a really strong start to his game. So moving into his first fight of the game, Noble does a great job of setting himself up on a high ground position while taking his initial shots. Unfortunately, he misses, but that's okay. One mistake he makes here, though, is letting his opponent get the jump on him and take height after the first few shots. You know, in situations like these, you've got to try and be the first one up. We saw how instead of just jumping up and ramping over the player, Noble decided to hop down and play low ground. He had materials, so ultimately, it was just a misplay on his part. However, you know, with some solid piece control, Noble's able to quickly clean up this kill and move on, so I guess it didn't turn out too bad. Alright, so in this next clip here, and I mean like right here, Noble finds himself in a bit of a scuffle with two other players, and he's on low ground. He makes a great play here, allowing his opponent to fight it out so he can just third party, and we'll see how this plays out in a second. This was one thing he struggled with before working with his coach, but he's seen a lot of progress, and he's able to handle third party situations way better now, and it's really helping a ton. So after waiting it out for a bit and hearing some shots exchange, Noble jumps out and takes height on the whole fight. He grabs an easy kill on the first player with a clean shot and makes a beautiful piece control play on the second to clean up it all. Alright, I'm telling you guys, like, wow. One amazing play Noble makes here, and one his coach always emphasized, was rotating to the dead side of zone to get more consistent placement. On the dead side, which is basically the side people aren't rotating into, usually near the water, there are almost no players around, making it easier to just rotate and set yourself up for a great end game. So Noble works his way over to this hill, and he sets up a base on this hill to wait out the second zone. The third zone comes in, and he's in it. However, here we go again, man. One cycle decides to push up and W key Noble despite him being in a great situation. I hate when that happens. Okay, so being confident in his mechanics and fighting ability, Noble is able to fight this player. He's able to turn the aggression right back on this guy and ends up getting a clean kill, allowing him to refresh his materials and continue playing his game out. Since the middle of zone is congested, despite it being the best spot, Noble is staying toward the edge since he has mobility to spare. He makes a nice on-foot rotation to the fourth zone and gets the fifth zone right on him, which is pretty cool. So he's able to look back and he gets a ton of shots on players. Unfortunately, he didn't get any kills in this process, but he was pretty darn close plenty of times. Yeah, I said the word darn, it's one of my favorite words. All right, so one minor mistake that I like to point out here is that when Noble launched to the sixth zone, he really didn't create much distance away from these players. You know, optimally, he either wanted to strafe a bit to avoid shots or hug the right side of the storm. However, he doesn't get punished too badly, which is pretty good. Another small mistake Noble makes is he's definitely overpeaking quite a bit. Looking at him in this situation from the outside, it's definitely possible for him to get sniped or just shot by another player. He definitely could be better off, you know, turning this into a simple window edit or just triangle edit to reduce the amount of his body that's showing. However, let me say this, like, he's still able to do okay here, and he ends up rotating with a crash pad. But one mistake I like to point out is that on this rotation, he used a lot of metal, making a full metal tarp into zone. He eventually switches to brick, but in this situation, it would definitely be better to conserve his metal and generally use up less builds. Unfortunately, despite him playing pretty good for this game, Noble gets himself caught on the backside of zone here. Okay, if you grind competitive, you know that one of the most important things in endgame is to stay ahead of the zone. Unfortunately, Noble seemed to panic in this situation and used his crash pad incorrectly, and instead of focusing on his rotation, he got caught up in the chaos, and in his panic, he decided to pop a mini instead of just continuing his rotation. He does end up getting a kill, but ultimately he's stuck in the storm and behind everybody, so his game comes to an end right here. So the biggest thing Noble should be focusing on in his endgame, like we just saw, is that he needs to focus on preserving his materials and prioritizing getting ahead of the zone during moving circles. Luckily, this is something that, you know, he's actively working on now, and I'm sure we're going to see a lot of progress with this issue moving forward. Overall, Noble had a great game here, and I mean like right here. And his progress from when he first started at Pro Guys is extremely clear in this game. In this game, he did a really great job approaching fights, really smart actually, like going for a preemptive damage from a good position. Also, he made a super intelligent play in his second fight, allowing the other two players to fight it out and get tags, then coming in to grab both the kills after they got low. Another big thing Noble did right is playing confidently, so important, and not being afraid of a player pushing him. So many people struggle with this, right? But through his coaching, he's been able to build up that confidence and improve drastically at fighting in-game. Finally, all right, two other things Noble has improved at are his peace control and his dead side rotations. Peace control helped a ton with the multiple kills he ended up getting, and those dead side rotates made a massive difference as well, allowing him to avoid the congested area of zone and get a lot of placement points. But with the good comes some bad as well. In this game, Noble did make a few mistakes, but that's what we're here for, right? Come on now. Spotting mistakes, that's what we do, man, and figuring out how to improve upon them. All right, so the first mistake he made in this game, guys, like, was when he launch padded. He didn't seem to make much of an effort to avoid other players. All right, so when you launch, especially in non-stacked games where players are more scattered than bunched together, it's important to try and strafe or hug an edge of the zone so you don't get lasered. Luckily, he didn't get lasered here, but it's definitely worth taking note of for the future. All right, so another issue he had in this endgame was simply over peeking. During that situation, he added a full arch, which fully exposed him, instead of a small window or something similar, which would have only exposed him for a tiny bit. Once again, he didn't get punished for it in this game, but it could have easily gone bad if a player realized what was going on. All right, one micro mistake that Noble made was how he used quite a few materials to rotate, building full boxes and using hard materials in situations where he really didn't need to. Conserving your material is huge in endgame, especially in solos, so this is just something that can definitely be improved upon. And the final thing we saw from Noble, which is one of the big things, you know, him and his coach have been working on, is trying to get ahead of moving zones instead of just getting caught behind. In this game, he started panicking and he stopped prioritizing his rotation, which ultimately led to his death. All right, next time, he should definitely try and focus on getting ahead or at least midway into the zone before he starts to heal or look for kills. However, despite these few mistakes, I gotta say this. Noble, he had a great game, and he really put on a clinic with some of these players. So dope. Overall, I want to say this, amazing job, Noble. It was great reviewing this one, and focusing on these things should help you a lot. Keep up the good work, bro, and you better keep eating that bunch of crunch. So these are the words from Thresh. Noble has immensely improved over a couple of sessions with me for sure. When he first came to me, he lacked so many of the basic fundamentals of Fortnite Battle Royale, but helping him and actually seeing him apply some of it into his gameplay has made me very proud. I'm very confident in his ability to continue his ascent to greatness once he has more time to keep practicing the things I teach him. All right, guys, once again, this is your motivation guide. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Make sure to connect with me on my Insta at your motivation guide. Crunchy Crunch Army. That includes this video. Thank you so much again for watching, man. If you guys want to receive this type of coaching, make sure to head on to ProGuys.com and check out the VOD review coaching system to send in a replay and get a video outlining the things that you need to work on. That's going to be it for today. Make sure you guys keep eating that bunch of crunch. And yo, man, just keep doing your thing. Keep doing your thing, all right? We'll see you guys soon. Peace.